Welcome back inside the Lux Hotel here in Beverly Hills for the LD Microcap Conference. And joining us now is Brian Murphy. He's the CEO of Emerald Bioscience. And Brian, great to see you again. How are you?
Great to see you as well. It's been about a year since we last chatted.
Lots of stuff to talk about. But before we get to that, let's just give everyone a quick update. Tell me a bit about the company and who you are.
So the company, Emerald Bioscience, focuses on the development of cannabinoid-based medicines, especially for conditions of urgent medical need. We are the sole development partner of the University of Mississippi, which still has the only federal license to grow, cultivate, and research cannabis autonomously in the United States. So you're looking at roughly 50 years of intellectual capital related to that university. And since we spoke last, we have entered into something called an all-fields license, whereby we have licensed both the prodrug of THC and an analog of CBD in a way that we can develop those molecules for any indication in any type of formulation delivered through any route of administration for both human and veterinary uses. So that was a major licensing deal that we were able to accomplish since the last time we spoke.
Well, it gives you an opportunity to go in a million different directions if you want to, right?
Correct. Yeah. And, you know, obviously as an early stage biotech company, we're going to focus on a few indications. But by virtue of those licenses, it does give us a little bit more versatility about potential business development and co-development deals with other companies, perhaps in areas where therapeutic areas where we're not currently focused.
Well, let's talk about a couple of the items that have happened over this year. First off, EMBI-3 glaucoma. Tell me about where that's at.
So, the code name for that drug is EMBI-1111.
Yeah.
And EMBI-1111 is a prodrug of THC. We have completed formulation work on that, and the formulation is a nano-emulsion eye drop for glaucoma. Since we last spoke last year, we've completed preclinical studies in rabbit, both normal and glaucoma settings, and we found that the drug is statistically superior to the top three most prescribed drugs that constitute about 90 to 95% of the market at lowering intraocular pressure. We've also completed some other studies to show that that drug is able to enter all chambers of the eye, especially the posterior chamber, where it can have a beneficial effect potentially on the optic nerve.
So will there be more? What goes next in 2020 for that?
So in 2020, we have already opened up our office affiliate in Australia.
Okay.
And starting in mid-2020, we are looking to gear up our work in Australia for the first human clinical trial.
Okay.
It'll be a phase one study for safety, and then a phase 2A study looking at a multiple ascending dose approach for the prodrug of THC.
Okay. Let's talk about CBD, because that's another big part of the company, and you've had some recent news about that.
CBD is a very, very hot area, and you see CBD everywhere.
Yeah.
What we want to do is be the company with actual outcomes research in CBD. We are taking a regulatory approach to get the drug formally approved. We have an ocular formulation for CBD that we've been able to show delivers superior antifibrotic, anti-inflammatory effects to cells of the eye, superior to just regular CBD.
Okay.
We've also just completed some in vitro studies in a validated model of neurologic tissue to show that the analog of CBD that we have is superior, actually delivers enhanced anti-seizure activity as opposed to just regular CBD. So we're very excited about that. As I mentioned, we've completed formulation work as far as the delivery to the eye, And we're currently looking at a number of different formulations for possible novel routes of administration of the analog into the body for other diseases.
So it seems like 2020 seems to be a pretty significant year for the company.
Absolutely. 2020 is going to be extremely pivotal. In addition to the human studies for glaucoma, and breaking out into doing further studies with the analog of CBD, especially looking into liver disease, given its antifibrotic activity. We'll also be hitting the patent clock for some of our molecules. We should be hearing from the patent and trademark offices of a number of different territories. So the prodrug of THC already has a global patent footprint out to 2034. The CBD analog we're waiting on in 2020 should be the year.
Fascinating stuff. Hey, great to catch up with you again.
Thank you so much.
It was great stuff.
Us.
All right, Brian Murphy, the CEO of Emerald Bioscience.